These are notebooks that I filled up with notes before I even started school. I was studying on my own for like weeks when I was, even when there was another biotechnology program that I was trying to get into before I even applied to Bunker Hill. And I couldn't get in like 2 years in a row. But yeah, this is other work that I did. This is some of the work that I did in school for this semester. I mean, I've talked about stuff like this before, but I don't think people really get it. You know, they don't understand. Like, I'm not some kind of like nerd that like can't relate in a normal way to other people. I just worked hard. I really worked hard. You know, these aren't even tests. This is stuff that I did to study, you know, studying our homework that I did. A lot of it is just like, you know, these are notes I took in class. That's what all, and I'm going to shred all of this today. I'm going to shred all of it because I have to have room for, you know, like the other stuff I'm going to be doing. Other things I'm going to be doing, I have to have room for it. You know, like I'm going to be starting school again, and I have to have, you know, a place to put my books. I have to have a place to put like my other, the other notes that I'm gonna take and the other homework that I'm gonna do. Yeah, but it was very painful. I mean, it was very painful, you know, to have asked for help, you know, getting harassed, you know, asked for help. Could you stop this person? All I was asking was, could you stop this person from harassing me? That is all I was asking for, you know, and instead the entire thing got turned back around on me, and I don't even know if they have talked to that guy yet. I really have absolutely no idea. You know, and I don't even know how to talk about this. I mean, one of these notebooks from when I did all of these when I was like still living in the shelter, and one of them has some notes from, you know, when there was a staff person, a male staff person who harassed me there for 8 months. 8 months, right, like right in front of other staff people, and you know, the people who were in charge, they didn't believe me. They wouldn't believe me. You know, they had other people telling, some of the people were telling them, yes, it's happening, you know, and it definitely was, but they thought it was funny or whatever. But it took 8 months of mine seeing something, and they wouldn't do anything about it, and finally he harassed so many other women that they finally fired him. But that's how long it took, you know, and it's just like, and I knew as soon as that guy started harassing me in that class, at school, you know, he's exactly the type, you know, he would sit there in the class, he wouldn't do anything for like the first half of the semester. He didn't need to, he already knew the subject, you know. It was probably the only class where my intelligence wasn't, you know, really as, I mean, he already knew the language, you know, so it really didn't have anything to do with being smart. He didn't have to do any of the work, because he already spoke. He was probably just there to, you know, get an A without even having to work at it. And he just sat there like lump, didn't do anything until, like, you know, a few weeks before the semester ended, he decided he was going to harass me. And then he turned into like the star, you know, and he just got away with it. He absolutely did. I don't think they have done anything to confront that guy. And not only that, I think I'm going to be not only as vulnerable to something like that happening to me again when I go back to school, but more vulnerable. Again, these are just my notes. This is not even stuff that anybody asked me to do. You know, this is just all these, and this isn't even, and these papers and everything, this is not even everything that I have. It's just, I mean, what am I going to do? I'm going to, you know, film an hour of a video showing all of the work that I did. I mean, the things that I filmed before are things like, you know, I've worked so hard on so many things. You know, and have really tried to put just like an effort into so many things, and it's just like, and the only thing that happens over and over again, I walk in to get some help somewhere, and they treat me like I'm crazy. It's my fault, you know. And literally, that's what happened. When I asked for help, I got sent to the dean's office, you know, until a couple of hours before I was at the dean's office. I thought it was because I was going to get some help, and not that I was going to be the one who was going to be accused of having done something wrong and treated like I don't have any social skills. Oh yeah, I don't have any social skills. And when I get upset, it's not because I've done all of this work, you know, to be good, to, you know, so I can get straight A's at school, which I didn't get. I actually got, I got 3 A's and an A minus, you know. And it's true. I know that those are good, but I could have had straight A's. I could have had straight A's, but I couldn't because I fell apart, you know, emotionally fell apart, because I knew that guy was gonna win. I knew it from the first day that it started. You know, as soon as I saw how persistent he was, as soon as I saw how much he didn't care, you know, about the way he was disrupting the classroom, you know, or how he was trying to upset me. That was his goal. He had probably seen the stuff about me online. you know, had seen these situations in which I was, you know, telling stalkers to leave me alone. And I have nothing to apologize for in terms of telling stalkers to leave me alone, because, you know, telling stalkers to leave me alone is the way that I did not get raped and did not get abducted and I'm in one piece and never got beat up. You know, I just have nothing to apologize for. I mean, what do you think it means to be homeless? Homeless. You know, and like, it wasn't even like homeless guys who like did the worst things. I mean, these guys were, you know, in their cars following me around day and night. You know, people with all their trucks, like, all, you know, stacked up behind each other. I mean, it's just like, you know, people, sometimes police officers would help them, you know, would like park in front of them. I mean, it was just like, it was just, it was, you know, life or death, really, pretty much. You know, perhaps not as severe as in other situations, but certainly it was something that could have turned into something way worse. You know, and I just worked so freaking hard, and to have somebody who doesn't care about school, somebody who has no motivation, somebody who just is just a bully, you know, and couldn't care less, and thinks it's funny to screw around in class. And I tried to be nice. I tried. At first, I tried to ignore it, you know, and then after a couple of classes, I mean, the class was a 3-hour class, and he would sit there, and he would cough for 2 hours. And he was not sick. He was lying. He thought it was funny. He disrupted the entire classroom. You know, he really did. He just took over the whole class. And all I was doing was trying to get through the class. I thought it was interesting. I wasn't mean to anybody. You know, I was as friendly as I could. You know, I was friendly. It was other people who started to be less friendly to me. You know, because for whatever reason, because he, you know, I saw him schmooze in the classroom, run around to people and talk to them and be like, you know, try to get, but they were kids. It's okay. I understand when people are young. You know, it's not, and that was something they tried to say about me too. When I was sent to the dean's office thinking that I was going to get help and instead got accused of being the one who was doing something wrong. You know, the idea that somehow I'm too old to be in the classroom. And there were, you know, certainly, I was not even the older person. I wasn't even the older person there. I wasn't the oldest student there. You know? It's just like, give me a break. But I was the oldest female person in the classroom. I think that certainly has something to do with it. You know, and I was motivated, and I did what I was supposed to do, and I asked questions. But I certainly did not, you know, prevent anybody else from asking questions. I wasn't rude to anybody. You know, I never did anything to anybody in that classroom, and the entire thing was a disgusting, horrifying lie. What happens to me? Everything that happens to me, it's just like, but it is over and over again. And those people win every time. They win every time. Maybe because they're just such liars. You know, there are some people who do not have a problem doing really, really bad things in lying. You know, and I am vulnerable to those people because of, you know, the things that are going on out there in the world. You know, and the way that I have to try to defend myself, you know, defend myself about it, it's like, you know, there's nothing I can do. You know, I have nothing to apologize for in terms of what I have been through and what I had to do to protect myself, you know, and get through from one day to the next. And I have nothing to apologize for as far as, like, you know, I mean, how much effort I put into being a good student. I don't need to apologize for being a good student. I mean, how dare you? How dare you accuse me of being someone who's, like, too motivated? I did not prevent anybody else's, like, you know, ability to learn anything in the classroom. I was not unsupportive of other people. I did not start anything with anybody, you know, and it's just, I mean, the way that people just, like, I don't even know, but I think there are people who are like that. They're just willing to lie, you know, they're willing to lie. Some people are willing to just flat out lie, because they want to do bad things, and they don't want to get in trouble, and they don't care about the harm they cause to other people. But I just put so much effort into it. And I'm telling you again, this isn't even all of it. This is not all. These are not all my notebooks. This is not everything that happened. This isn't. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's truly disgusting. You know, it's truly disgusting. And as far as this is concerned, I see people are making a big deal out of this paper. You know, I couldn't use it. The one thing that was difficult in terms of how school started, I was homeless for the first 6 weeks of school. I continued to be homeless for the first 6 weeks of school. You know, I did not have my own, place. Was living in a homeless shelter. Had a curfew. Had to get up at 6 o'clock every single morning, including on the weekends. You know, had to also just deal with being homeless. You know, for the first 6 weeks of school, I had to find some place where I could sit and study. I really couldn't use the library on a regular basis because I would get harassed. People cough over and over again. They just thought it was funny. They didn't care, you know? So, and also, you know, so I couldn't, so the one thing that I really had trouble with, you know, for the first half of school, particularly because, you know, having to work around a homeless shelter schedule, I had a curfew. I had to be there by like 10, you know, and even that was extended, you know, that was an extended curfew because I had school. So I just, you know, and plus having to go to class, plus, you know, the other things you have to do when you're just a person, you know, and so the most difficult part of it was I didn't have a computer. You know, I mean, I have a tablet, the keyboard doesn't work. Literally the keyboard just doesn't work. So I couldn't, you know, and as far as like using the computers at school to do the research and stuff, I couldn't, you know, I really, when I was there, people would harass me. So I really could only take it for so long, in addition to not really having a lot of blocks of time that I could use. And I asked, some people are making a big deal out of this paper. What do you think? You think this is the best paper I ever wrote? This, first of all, is a rough draft, right? And the reason I got upset with it when I saw my grade of an 88 is that because before he handed back these papers, he said, this is a teacher in another one of my classes. The only other class where I had a problem, and I didn't even know I had a problem until I found out what this teacher was saying about me, to school administrators. I was like, I asked him in an email. I was like, look, you know, I really need help. Could you, there is an internet connection and a computer for this particular program at the homeless shelter, but I'm not allowed to use it because I'm not in that program. Can you just, you know, could you maybe contact the director of the shelter to explain to her why I need to use that computer? And first he said he would, and then he said he wouldn't. And I was like, all right, you know, all right, you know what? All right. And the thing is too, as far as being in the library to use the computers there, I would get harassed. So it's painful to be around all those people anyway. It's painful. What do you think? You think I don't feel anything about what's happening to me? Do you honestly think that I enjoy the fact people say all the things they say about me? Do you really honestly think that I enjoy the fact that there are naked videos of me out there in the world that all sorts of people are seeing that I never consented to? You know, that were filmed with hidden cameras in homeless shelters and psychiatric units. Like, do you honestly think I want people to know all this stuff about me? That all this stuff that people say about me is how I want other people to think about me, and I'm just enjoying all the attention? Really? You really think that? You really think so? You really think, continuing to think, it's appropriate just to call me a dumb slut in answer to everything that I say? You really think so? How many more of those do there have to be? I don't know how many more of those there are going to be. Because I don't know if I'm going to be able to get through school. I don't know which jerk is going to hassle me next and screw up my months, my hours and days and months of work that I have put into my life just to have it ruined by whoever feels like ruining it, and then lying to people who are happy to believe them because it's just too much trouble to have me around, even though I'm not the one who's doing something wrong, right? Oh, you think? I mean, as far as this paper is concerned, I literally had to finish it and just, you know, send it the way that it was. Somehow I couldn't make the formatting work when I was on the computer, and I think I had even sent him an email about that too, like, I don't know what's going on, but I can't make this computer format anything. Yeah, you know, and these are some of the notes from that guy's class that I took in class. Apparently he's a stickler for paper formatting. Gosh, I'm sorry that I'm homeless. Sorry that I'm homeless. Sorry I don't have a computer. You know, sorry, all my other classes I could just kind of do the work for it because, you know, they had books, and it wasn't something that was dependent on the computer, dependent on the library, you know, and the computerized library or any of that stuff. But this was the hardest thing, writing my papers. You know, I read the short stories he asked us to read. I wrote about them, you know, with stuff that I could write, just write it down on paper. I did that and did all of that stuff, you know, and as far as this computer, you think because I asked for your help about this and you said no. And as far as my getting upset about him having given me an 88 on it, it's like, you know what? Because what he told everybody else in the class before he handed back the papers was he gave everybody basically a starting grade of C, and all you had to do was turn in the paper to not fail. And my having read the things that other people had written, I could tell, and it's not their fault that many of them really, really don't even know how to write a grammatically correct sentence because, you know, because the public school system has failed them. You know, and it's not a question of my being snobby. I understand what some of my advantages have been, but that doesn't mean that I'm not poor. I'm as poor as anybody else who, you know, just doesn't even have $1,000 a month to live on, you know? But I mean, the idea that somehow I'm setting myself up to be like, you know, putting myself out there, oh, Stanley, see this perfect paper that I wrote and he wasn't fair to me and blah, blah, blah. That is not what I said. I have never said that. This is what really happened.